r/AskReddit. People who have cheated on their SO. Why didn't you just end the relationship? I have cheated once. I loved this guy more than I can say in words, but we did not have a healthy relationship. He cheated on me. I even caught him once in bed with another man and I stayed with him anyways, because he was my world. He was my best friend. He was my family. But we didn't have sex. It killed me inside. I would show up at his house wearing nothing but lingerie and a fur coat. I wish this was a made up story by FML. It isn't, and he would ignore me. I didn't feel like I was attractive or sexy, and it got to the point where I didn't think he would even care if I had sex with someone else. So one night, I was out at a show with a bunch of people, including a guy I had an innocent crush on, and we ended up kissing. One kiss. I felt terrible about it afterwards. Sick. I confessed to my boyfriend and he went insane. He punched the windshield of my car and shattered it while I was driving. It was bad. He felt betrayed. Looking back at this 20 years later, it's obvious what was going on, but I didn't see it at the time. I was young, naive, and he was everything to me. I regretted hurting him then, and I still regret it to this day. I have never cheated on anyone again. Cheating isn't the answer. Talk it out, work it out, or get out. Edit. Wow, I didn't expect this to blow up like it did. Thank you all so much for the really supportive and kind comments. And to clear things up, I'm a female. Edit 2. Since a lot of you have commented on my statement about it's obvious what was going on and wonder what I meant by this, he was into dudes and I think he was very conflicted about it at the time. Because I justified to myself that it wasn't cheating at first. I've never told this story before, but I was in a relationship that I was pretty unhappy in. It wasn't just the relationship, I was depressed and scared of being alone, so I didn't end it when I should have. We moved in together, and things got worse. My girlfriend was bisexual and had some interest in a threesome. I was somewhat detached from the relationship at the time, and had met a new girl at work, who I had a lot of chemistry with. I was in the service industry at the time and there was lots of after work drinks and me and this girl were hitting it off. I told my girlfriend about her, strictly mentioning the physical aspect, and she told me to pursue it. I did and we all went out for drinks one night and it happened. It was very strange, because it hit me during that I had real feelings for the other girl. My girlfriend had to work early, but as she left she told us to have fun, which I took full advantage of. After that I started seeing the other girl somewhat regularly, and was officially cheating. I found out a few weeks later that my girlfriend knew, and thought it would lead to a fun partner for us, but in actuality I was falling for the other girl. Her being cool with it did not last long, big surprise, but by that time it was all over, and I was madly in love with the other girl. We have been together ever since, and married for 3 years with a new baby. I will always feel terrible about how things ended. I was a complete coward, and should have come clean as soon as I started having feelings for the other girl, but I hid what was really happening, which hurt my girlfriend at the time tremendously. Last I heard and saw, she was doing great things in her life and was in a great relationship. I wish so much that I could go back and undo the hurt I caused her, but that is something I will always have to live with. I kissed a colleague while completely drunk off my face on a night out. I don't remember it happening, but when I woke up the next morning I just knew to the pit of my stomach I had kissed this guy, and I had completely and utterly fucked up, and had no idea why. We'd been together for 3 years, met at 19 in college. He was honestly the perfect guy, someone who ticked all the boxes, kind, smart, great family and job, similar friends, attractive. The spark and sex life died about a year before we broke up, and I think I wasn't ready to acknowledge this was the end of the road for us. We'd try to talk through my lack of sex drive, but it got to the point where I would avoid initiating any kissing because of the huge amount of guilt I'd feel for not wanting to have sex, but also feeling like a shitty partner for not having ever wanting to have sex. I'd been out before and gotten drunk and nothing like this had ever happened. I had to really think about why I'd ever do something like this, and coming to the realization I wasn't in love anymore, even though he was such an incredible guy, broke my heart. The first year or so, we were so in love, but at some point I had fallen out of love, but I was trying to persevere in the hope that feeling would come back. There was also this weird pressure, in that everyone would comment he would never break up with me, because he was so in love with me, and he'd poke fun that he loved me more than I loved him. Doing long distance for a year and me starting work first, while he finished college, probably accelerated me growing apart. I never ever thought I would be the one who cheat. I had such high moral standards for others and myself, and I'm still disappointed today that I cheated. I took a year to work on myself and what I wanted, and looking back now, I was probably in denial about it being over for me, but I stayed together because he was perfect, just not for me. It's been a year, and he was nothing but a gentleman. When people asked why we broke up, leaving out the kiss and telling them it was sudden breakup, but he respected my decision. I hear he's seeing someone else now, and I hope it works out for him. He does deserve the best. I tried to end it. We started dating August 2012. I was 21, and he was 33. By December, I knew I didn't want to be with him anymore. He was moody, insecure, and not someone I saw myself with long term. He wanted kids. I had zero intention. He wanted to settle down. I wanted to adventure. We were broken up for 2 weeks before he convinced me to get back with him, crying and saying he'd been drunk the whole time missing me. We eventually moved in together by February. He left me at a bar 3 separate times. The first was when I took too long to pick up weed from my guy down the street. I accidentally walked past his house and had to double back. I got back to the bar and my ex was gone. I got home and he accused me of cheating. The second time was after my best friend's going away party. It was the end of the night, we were finishing drinks, and I said I was going to the bathroom. When I came out, he was gone. I thought maybe the bar had kicked him out cause it was 2:30. I waited outside for him for half an hour before I got a text from him saying you can pick up your shit from the front lawn tomorrow. After getting home, I found out he thought I said I don't wanna be with you anymore when I went to the bathroom. The final time was during the downfall of our relationship. By this time it was October 2013 and we had moved to the other side of town. I had a crappy minimum wage job and he was a sound engineer for a local venue. We were pretty broke. At the bar, I had ordered 2 drinks but miscalculated my money. I asked him for a couple bucks to cover. He blew up on me, and maybe I deserved it, but once again he stormed off and left me at the bar. So I stuck around and got my drinks paid for by someone with whom I eventually made out with and went home with, because fuck my ex. How many times am I gonna get left by someone who loves me? A week later we were drinking, started fighting, and the cops were called. We both got taken into the station, and when I got out the next day I moved out. Unfortunately that wasn't the end of it, but that's the gist of it. Going off topic, but I have been struggling with this for a few weeks now. I feel that confessing to strangers is better than actually saying anything to a person I know. About 11 years ago, I was dating a very good person. Looking back, it was probably the most wholesome relationship I have ever been involved with. Every day spent with her was fantastic. I would, and did, literally, walk 5 miles to her house during a snowstorm, so I could see her. As time went on and our relationship progressed, I became more complacent. I just assumed we would be together forever. She is a year younger than I am, and took 2 years off of school before going to college. So as I was finishing my education, she was just starting. After she decided to move an hour away to go to school, I started becoming more and more possessive. I didn't want her to spend time with her friends. I said some terribly mean things and eventually destroyed the relationship. Although it was a mutual breakup, I know that I was completely to blame for things. The hell of it is, for nearly 2 years, every time I would find myself getting close to another girl, I would get a call or message from her. Just hearing from her would send me into a whirlwind of emotion. Hopes would flare inside of me, just hoping that enough time had passed to heal old wounds. Each time would end the same. Knowing how poorly I treated her toward the end of our relationship, I can't blame her for not welcoming me back. Finally, and the last time I ever spoke to her, about 8 years ago, she called me, obviously distraught in her then relationship. She asked me, was I a bad girlfriend? At this point in time, I was just progressing into a new relationship that I did not want to sabotage. I was drinking at that point and feeling no pain. I very bluntly blamed every problem with us directly on her. I don't think I will ever forgive myself for the things I said. As I mentioned earlier, she was a genuinely good person. She didn't deserve the way I treated her that night. Looking back, I wish I was more mature. I wish I was more outgoing, as I could have found plenty of work with my degree in a college town. She isn't the one that got away, she is the one that should have been. In the odd chance she sees this, I'm sorry, Krista. I hope things turned out best for you. I was 16 years old, and I started dating my first girlfriend. She was a grade above me, and Yano first love yada yada. We were very bought into the whole Prince Charming, one true pair, yada yada. Girlfriend left to college, while I was a senior in HS still. After a few months of only seeing each other on weekends, I started to develop feelings for another girl. I didn't ever not love my girlfriend at that time, and still think to this day I have love for her, but I recognized that you can love and be physical with more than one person if you are honest and open. My girlfriend and I's distance, combined with us seeing monogamy as our only option due to mainstream media and shaming from peers, made me feel trapped in a corner about my feelings towards the other girl, so I just selfishly snuck around with the other girl despite me wanting to just talk about it with my GF. I was 18, and I couldn't communicate my feelings well, and I couldn't comprehend the way my actions could impact others. I loved my GF and still had feelings of physical and emotional attraction to someone else, and that is not bad or wrong, and not something to be ashamed of. What was wrong was not telling my GF upfront that I had developed those feelings, and that my feelings for her were still there, and that there are layers and dimensions to physical and emotional relationships. It blew up in my face, but it was good, because it made me recognize that I was polyamorous, and that I needed to find partners that were open and aware of that. This thread has a lot of shaming of those who have feelings for more than one person. Having feelings is not wrong. What is wrong is lying to your partner or partners about what you're doing / about the nature of your relationship. I'm so much happier now, knowing how and when to communicate with my partner and not be scared due to societal norms to mold myself to monogamy. I hate that I had to learn this by cheating, by hurting someone else, but I'm happy I learned it and understand myself and my needs in a relationship, because I feel happier and better. We were together far longer than we should have been, and far longer than we probably would have if he hadn't gone into the military. We were both freshmen in college when we met, and I was a sheltered, not allowed to date kid. He was almost literally the first boy I met who I actually thought was cute, and who thought the same of me. We broke up briefly a few months in, because he was talking to an ex, and I found out that it was very non-platonic, and she wanted him to leave me and get back together with her. We got back together about a month later, and stayed together after he dropped out of college to go into the military. Our relationship lasted over 2 years, and we even got engaged. However, I met this new friend and slowly realized that our friendship was healthier than my relationship. I was more intelligent than my ex, and felt we couldn't talk about anything because of time difference, where he was stationed and different intellects. I was finally able to have deep conversations about science, history, art, etc., and not have to explain seemingly, to me, simple concepts. My ex was street smart, but not book smart. Finally, things sort of escalated into more than platonic with the new guy. He was actually the first person I told out loud that I wanted and needed to break up with my ex before anything had happened. However, my ex was stationed 3 time zones away, and breaking off an engagement isn't something you do over the phone. I waited about 2 months until I saw him to actually say it. He knew it was coming, based on some phone conversations and how I was acting, but it was still awful. The new guy and I backed up for some time while I grieved the relationship and worked through my feelings of guilt, heartbreak, regret, relief, guilt for feeling relief, and everything else that comes with a breakup. He never found out I cheated, and I've been happily with the other guy for almost 4 years now. I will never tell him, because breaking up with him alone broke his heart and devastated him. I was told for years and years that ending a relationship in any way other than in person is cowardly and the shittiest thing you can do to a person. I was barely out of my teens and in a long distance relationship, think different continents, that wasn't much of a relationship really. He never could find the time to talk to me, but somehow found time for everything else, and would pretty much only contact me to dump his problems on me, talk about all the exciting girlfriends in his life, or ask me to do things for him. I didn't break up with him because I felt I could never find someone else who would like me, and because, as mentioned, I believed it was incredibly scummy to break up with someone via the internet. We had a visit planned for ages, but then 2 weeks before it was supposed to happen, he told me he had changed his mind and would rather I didn't come. We hadn't seen each other for months at this point. It was a weird situation. I didn't want to argue, so I just said okay, whatever, and ended the call. I was really sad and angry, got drunk, and slept with someone. The next day, my long distance ex contacted me to ask if I was okay, and to say again that he really didn't want me to come visit. We didn't really talk much after that, and while I broke it off with him in person to make it official, he admitted later that uninviting me was his way of initiating the breakup. He just didn't want to be the bad guy, so he left it to me. Thanks, ex. I'm not actually sorry I did what I did, and I don't consider it cheating other than in the most technical of senses. I just like to contribute my story to threads like these, so people know it's not always black and white, loving relationship that gets wrecked because of one person's selfishness. I do wish I didn't believe people who told me I can never break up with someone via text, because it would have made this situation so much easier to navigate. Oh hey, this counts I think. Everything that happens is online. I'm an absolute fiend when it comes to guys who are not in my time zone. Long story short, I was on a break with my ex due to some shit he had done, threatening suicide and then laughing at me when I got upset after trying to play his game of try and stop me by doing this incredibly dumb thing, and I couldn't do it. So he kept telling me whenever he failed that he got another try then thanks to me. That, among a lot of other things that were pretty horrendous. Not trying to justify myself, just trying to show the headspace I was in. So I'm on this break, and one of my friends who has been checking on me continuously due to knowing how fucked up my ex has me from everything, we start spending more time together, and he's very nice, and treats me like a friend, listens to me, takes what I say into consideration, doesn't tease me or tell me I'm stupid. I initiated flirting with him, and it felt good. My relationship with my ex is one where I never received compliments, never felt wanted or desired, but he'd still want me send him lewd pictures and do stuff on cam for him. This new relationship with my friend was a complete 180. We sent pics back and forth, heavy flirting, some cam stuff, etc. It took me cheating to realize I didn't deserve the shit my ex had put me through, that I deserved love and kindness just like anyone else, that I deserved to be appreciated by someone, that I was worthy. I broke up with my ex a few days after the pics and stuff, because I knew that I wasn't going back to him. At first my friend and I decided we'd keep flirting and stuff like that for fun, because we both really enjoyed it and we're consenting adults. But he didn't want to get involved in long distance, since he had had an LDR that ended badly. So I agreed to the terms and we enjoyed our time together so much, so that it got to the point where he was sleeping in a call with me due to me not sleeping well at all due to anxiety. That turned into me reading him to sleep at night, which also helped my anxiety out, and I would sleep through the night. Then we realized, oh shit, I really like this person and I don't want this to end. It's been a year, we are planning to meet sometime soon. I love him to death, and I'm glad I did what I did, even though sometimes I feel guilty about it. My boyfriend at the time was away in a 4-year college after I'd asked him again and again to stay at community college, like I had, because it was cheaper. Our relationship was barely alive by a thread and he refused to get a job. His car broke down, so he couldn't make the 2-hour commute, except when his friends had parties, and I was left working a job, doing 2 classes over full time, like 6 total, so I could get my associate's degree, and move up with him, and taking every weekend I had off to go see him. One day he smacks me with wanting an open relationship. I was really hurt at first, but I was young and stupid and decided okay. I loved him for him, not his body. Turns out college girls don't like sour wet blankets that sit in their dorm playing Dota all day. He didn't have a job, neither of his parents had real jobs. So FAFSA paid a good chunk, and he failed all his classes, because he has ADHD, and was simply too lazy to get up before 1 o'clock, and go to class. I, assuming we were doing the open relationship thing, got some with a nice young man I'd known for a while who I knew would be safe, and was cool with it. My boyfriend immediately says that the open relationship thing was just him being angry, and he didn't really mean it, and tells everyone I cheated on him. Tells the boy I was with that I lied about the open relationship, and was just straight up cheating. I lost a lot of friends because of it. And being young and stupid, stayed with that manipulative fuck for 2 more years. He dropped out, we moved in together, and he'd break up with me every couple months, not be my boyfriend, and then decide he wanted to be again. Finally moved into a 2-bedroom apartment during one of these breakup periods. He insisted we were done, and he wanted nothing to do with a relationship. Through pure nepotism, he had gotten an online job through his uncle, and spent all of his time sitting at his computer, playing Dota and pretending to work. He said we were just roommates and this went on for 4 months. Eventually I met my current so, and started dating him. Ex and I had discussed it, and he said he'd have no qualms bringing a girl home, so I should move on myself. At that point I'd gotten over him, so I was fine, if he got a new girlfriend. Again, did you know girls don't like sour wet blankets that hide in their apartment all day? So my so starts coming around. Immediately my ex demands a second chance. I say absolutely not, we had this worked out, it's not changing. He insists he's the reason I have everything I do. I owe him. He deserves more than being cast aside like garbage. What had he done to me months prior? So he tries again and again, getting more angry, saying I'm a cunt for not dumping my new BF, and getting back with him. I hold my ground, and he moves out. Now he's going around acting like I cheated on him again. I have a history after all, and he left me for it. Probably off mooching in someone else's basement, until they get sick of him. Basically this fuckhead decided that when a relationship looked like real work he was gonna wheel out and try to fuck some randos, but when I had better game I was a cheater. I regret neither of my cheating incidents. Never cheated personally, but I did know someone a few years back, A, who was cheating on their partner, B, with a friend of mine, 1, who was also cheating on their partner, 2. It was sort of a clusterfuck. They were all flatmates, and in the end everyone in the house knew what was going on except for one poor guy, B, who was considering marriage to A. At the time my husband and I had sort of sparse information related to us through our friend, 1, but 1 was awfully dodgy about it. He'd always frame things to make it seem like they either weren't cheating and just messing around a little, or like he was the victim. There were even some times he'd suggest A was taking advantage of him without consent, but when we urged him to take action it would come out that it was consensual or just flirting, or some other excuse. We never knew what was going on, and to be honest I didn't want to know anymore. I was beginning to aggressively flirt with my husband as well during this same time period and the two of us just wanted out of all the drama. The thing is, we knew a hell of a lot more than B did about all this. I was never close with B, and was even told on occasion that he didn't like me much, but it was cruel of us to leave him in the dark like that. I'm seeing the posts here by people who have been cheated on, and how the most painful part was always feeling like a fool. I've really regretted contributing to that feeling, and B, we should have told him everything, but even if we weren't sure what was true, we could have at least told him about how his partner was flirting with mine. He deserved better, and we really dropped the ball. Yes, it can be hard to know what to do, but there was no responsible way for us to extract ourselves from the drama. We were a part of it, whether we liked it or not, and to try and deny that was incredibly lazy and selfish. For us, inactivity was our real contribution, and it's a very real one. The shittiest thing is, that was really our only reason for not doing the right thing in that situation. There was no good excuse. It was just easier in the moment to back off than it was to talk it out. Thank you so much for watching the whole video. Please leave a like and subscribe.